We'll toss it to the Road Running Shoe Matrix. Road Running Shoe Matrix. Actually, no. We will toss it to the Matrix playlist. Oh, Nelly. Let me shimmy in the studio. Countdown mode, you better believe it. Cheers, everybody. Little survival vlog today. You know when you're training hard and you just feel a little murky, you know? That's what I'm going through right now, 100%. After, well, this on Monday, little FKT action up on Mount Elbert, and then the very following day, heading up Pikes Peak.
Hey, let's go.
And
Let's
meeting that
go.
guy on the way down, I still don't know his name. Oh man, I hope I get to. I bet he's training for. Hopefully the mayor. Hopefully I get to meet you, sir. Hopefully you're watching this right now. Again, the most enthusiastic. Oh my goodness, butter my bread I've ever heard up on the mountains. But here we go. We're surviving. We're talking about the Olympics today. We're talking about six shoes that I'm just devastated. Is that too strong of a word? Very sad to hit 50 miles in, okay? Very rarely do I put sad in the title of a vlog, but I'll get to those six shoes in a minute. And then also I want to talk about, this came up on Discord, was it Q's the runner up in Syracuse basically asked the question, what three or four shoes am I most excited about in the next 365 days? So I will let you know my top. I'll do three road shoes, three trail shoes, for the 50-mile devastation, and then also the predictions for the future. Okay, here we go. Road shoe matrix. Hold on one sec. Oh, that's good. And you better believe pretzels and peanut butter is fueling me right now. Oh man. And yes, I'm not just drinking coffee all day long. Don't you worry. I got my electrolyte mix inside. I got tea inside, but little pick-me-up every now and then is a must. Okay, so in case you missed it, yesterday we made our predictions for the Olympic marathon prediction contest for men and women. Gold, silver, bronze. Gold, silver, bronze. Okay, it's again listed down below in the description in case you haven't made your prediction yet. You can go fill it out and get your chance at winning a carbon fiber plate racing shoe. All right, if somebody can pick the winners there. All right, oh man, I cannot wait to see how many Magic Speed Skies are on the feet of the racers compared to, yes, Adidas and Nike. On that note, Road Running Shoe Matrix, upper right-hand corner, but people are starting to ask a lot about the Trail Running Shoe Matrix. So what is today? I think you're watching this on Friday. I'm headed to BV slash Leadville. If you're in the area, give a wave. I might be on the trails up there somewhere in the 14ers in the next couple of days, and I need to test probably two or three more shoes before I give you the, I think it's three actually. Another pair just arrived. So three more shoes before I create the Trail Running Shoe Matrix. But if you want to see 2020's Trail Running Shoe Matrix, again, upper right-hand corner, or I will link to it down below in the description. Okay, here we go. Let's break it down. Three road shoes, three trail shoes that I was very sad to hit 50 miles in, meaning, you know, I take shoes to 50 miles in order to give you my 50-mile full review. And here we go. Let's just list them off. Okay, for the road side, we're going Mach 4 is the first one, Hoka Mach 4. Next is the New Balance Rebel V2. And third, probably a surprise, and this was very difficult to choose, was the New Balance Fresh Foam More V3. Okay, so we got them all actually out here. Here is the Fresh Foam More V3, the Rebel V2, and here is the Mach 4 over here. Even though I tested this shoe in late 2020. So the ride, the fit of the Mach 4, and it's hard to choose one. I think the combo, so I think they Hoka needs to evolve a little bit with their EVA midsoles, but the combination of the ProFly midsole foam, it just rides so smooth underfoot, but I think the highlight of the shoe is a lockdown over the top of the foot. You all know how much I love that shoe, so I was very sad to hit 50 miles in this guy. Now, kind of the opposite side of the spectrum with respect to the durometer score is the Rebel V2. Many of you have already picked this shoe up. And the reason it made me very sad to get to 50 miles is it's fast, it's light, it's peppy, but it's also forgiving under step. When I'm running high mileage, and on that note, when I'm running high mileage, my legs get tired. And when I'm doing a lot of vertical gain, my legs get tired. You guys are out there doing, you know, many of you out there doing the same as many of you get ready for your fall marathon. It's very exciting on the Facebook group. It's listed down below to see people. In fact, if you could, head over to the Facebook group and start posting some photos of you training for Boston, for New York. Like, okay, the Olympics, very exciting. But this fall marathon season is gonna be unlike any other. Chicago, I mean, all the marathons from spring 2021 were basically bumped, not all, but most were bumped to fall. So anyway, post on the Facebook group your training, the shoes you're training in, and here's the deal. When I'm like 2 weeks ago, I had already taken the Fresh Foam More V3 past 50 miles, and I opted for this shoe out of the entire pile of shoes that I could have worn to just baby the legs. All right, this is my number one easy day running shoe thus far from 2021. Now you might be wondering, wait a minute, Seth, where is the Nova Blast? You would be correct. It was so hard to not include the Nova Blast 2 in my top three shoes that I was most sad. And I think this topic originally came up actually on Twitter, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so, oh, so good. There, okay, there's my three road shoes. Now, onto the trails. Here we go. This is crazy. Throwback 2019. All right, I'm just going to say it. The Evo Speed Goat. You know, I just keep harping on that shoe and harping on that shoe. I cannot wait, and we'll get to that in a second. But the Hoka Evo Speed Goat, the Salomon Ultra Glide. So here, there's the Evo Speed Goat. It's still surviving out here in the studio. The Salomon Ultra Glide. Okay, it's crazy though. I'm not quite to 50 miles in this shoe, but it's going to get there, and I'm going to be devastated to hit 50 miles. Like, I love the Ultra Glide. Now, a lot of you want to see a battle between these two shoes. You know what? Let's put them on the scale. I think this is maybe an ounce heavier. Let's put it on the scale. Since we're here, let's bring a little more value. Attempt to bring you some value. I think we're like 7.6 in my size, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, way off. Okay, sorry, way off. 8.6 for the Evo Speed Goat in my size. Ultra Glide, 9.3. So about a half an ounce, a little over a half an ounce. So pretty close, actually. So a running shoe battle is in the works between the Evo Speed Goat and the Ultra Glide, just so you are aware. And last but not least, for my trail shoe that I will be very sad to hit 50 miles in. Where is it? Where is it? I brought it out here. There it is. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. Very subtle colorway. I like it, Salomon. The Pulsar from Salomon. I'm a little perplexed by the feel I'm getting through the material on the upper of the toe box. It just feels funky. It needs a little break-in time, perhaps. But I gotta tell ya, oh, Nelly. I'm so close to 50 miles. It's very close. But this guy, I'm going to be very sad to hit 50 miles in. The Salomon Pulsar, which I don't think is quite shipping yet. I think it's going to be happening in like mid-August, if I'm not mistaken. So there you go. There are my top six shoes that thus far in 2021, very sad to hit 50 miles in. Now, here we go. My top three on both sides, road and trail, that I'm excited for in the next 365 days. You ready for this? Here we go. Nova Blast 3. Okay, I went there. Mach 5, oh, we talk so much about the Mach 4. Just even saying those words, Mach 5, gets me excited. All right, Mach 5, next percent 3. Okay, I don't know if it's going to be called that, but yeah, I'm pretty excited about that update. I hope they make a little more of a push in 2022, because the next percent to the next percent 2, not a huge update. All right, so there you go, Nova Blast 3. Mach 5, next percent 3. Okay, those are my road options. All right, on the, I gotta go there. So it's 2 of these. So the Evo Speed Goat 2, Hoka, come on, let's make this happen. Evo Speed Goat 2, Pulsar 2, yep, I went there. And last but not least, the, oh, actually it is here. I forgot. Ultra Glide 2, okay? Ultra Glide 2 is the other one. I'm just that excited. So it's those three that I'm excited for in 2022. And that topic did, I know for a fact, come up on Discord. So thanks for getting the conversation going out here in the studio. Here we go. Comment of the day, question of the day. Let's actually do the question of the day first. What would you, out of all of your interests, your hobbies, your passions on this earth, what would you rate a 10 out of 10? All right, or a bare 9.999, if you're not a 10 out of 10 type of person, 9.999, like, are you an artist and you have a favorite piece of art somewhere in a museum around the world, and when you see that piece of art, you're just like, yeah, that's a 10 out of 10. Or for me, I kind of geek out sometimes about cameras, sometimes. And so some cameras, I'm like, oh man, or drones, ooh, that's a 10 out of 10. So what would you rate on Earth 10 out of 10? Maybe it's a food or a recipe or a cup of coffee, like a type of coffee. Oh my goodness. The list is endless. I can't wait to read your comments. It's got to be 10 out of 10 or very close to a 10 out of 10. Okay, here we go. Comment of the day. This is actually just like riffing off of the comment of the day from 2 days ago. It got this person, Fine Line Industries. It's a YouTube channel that, I guess, I don't know. It's Fine Line Industries is the name of the YouTube channel. But this person said, you can have excuses or you can have results. I used this as motivation this morning as I did sprint intervals, was deep in the pain cave this morning, deep. Fine Line Industries, I love the fact that the comment of the day from 2 days ago was your fuel for your run this morning. Fine Line Industries, you get the comment of the day. Everyone, that's it. Again, a little bit of survival mode right now, eating my pretzels, drinking a little espresso in the afternoon, and just a little murky. A little in the pain cave, like you, this comment of the day person. I mean, it's just like we're just surviving and waiting for Pike's Peak to get here, is frankly. Like, I'm feeling very, very fit, ready to rock and roll soon. Not quite yet, but every now and then I just got to hop in the studio and record a vlog like this. Hopefully I brought you a little bit of value in these running shoe thoughts. Let's go, let's go. All right, we will toss it to we'll toss it to the Road Running Shoe Matrix. Road Running Shoe Matrix. Actually, no. We will toss it to the Matrix playlist. I have a playlist with all the Matrix vlogs. Right there. Matrix playlist. Right there. All right, everyone. Seek beauty. Work hard and love each other. See you tomorrow.